Minimum temperatures between 0 and minus 2 degrees Celsius. That's 32 to 28 degrees Fahrenheit. It's 10:05.
Music from the Motor City.
One, two.
No, no, yeah.
And in this latest broadcasting review, the BBC wishes to announce its firm commitment to the continuation of local radio. It would like to prove this by cutting it by a further £3 million.
Wanna do you feel, believe the way I feel for you. Chaka Khan, let me tell you what I wanna do. I wanna love you, wanna hug you, wanna squeeze you too. And let me take it in my arm, let me fill you with my charm, Chaka. Cause you know that I'm the one to keep you warm, Chaka. I make it more than just a physical dream. I wanna rock you, Chaka, baby, cause you make me wanna scream. Let me rock you, rock you.
Music from the Motor City. Music.
City.
Thank you.
Shaka Khan, let me rock you, let me rock you, Shaka Khan. Let me rock you, that's all I wanna do. Shaka Khan, let me rock you, let me rock you, Shaka Khan. Let me rock you 'cause I feel for you. Shaka Khan, won't you tell me what you wanna do? Do you feel for me the way I feel for you? Shaka Khan, let me tell you what I wanna do. I wanna love you, wanna hug you, wanna squeeze you too. And let me take you in my arms, let me fill you with my charm, Shaka. 'Cause you know that I'm the one that keep you warm, Shaka. I make it more than just a physical dream. I wanna rock you, Shaka, 'cause you make me wanna scream. Feel for you.
Music from the Motor City.
I don't know who he is. He just keeps saying that. By the way, this is the Late No-Known Crew. I'm Chris Morris. Good evening. This is your local BBC radio station. And in case you weren't listening just before 10 o'clock and you have only just tuned over from BBC Two, Radio Two, in fact, then this is the sort of thing that you were missing. There's some music to commit suicide to in a slightly odd kind of way. And Mr. Kipling's cakes had bits of glass in them last week. I always prefer my apple pies to be glazed. Never had anyone complain about crunchy apples before. I already have several people calling to say that they actually don't believe that what I just played was actually on Radio 2 earlier tonight, just before 10 o'clock. It went like this. Oh, it actually comes from, this is a programme called The Organist Entertains, presented by Nigel Ogden, who has the distinction of presenting perhaps the least well-named programme on radio. Well, I'm going to give away tonight Tina Turner's LP, which is called Foreign Affair. And also, Welcome to the Beautiful South, still as we are, blessed with a complete dearth of quality albums released this year, apart from The Christians, which I'll probably give away next week. So, two questions about that coming up pretty shortly. Wayne Carr, your favourite daytime jock, will be around, no doubt, later on. We'll be rifling through the week's news. There's a phoning competition also to take part in around 11 o'clock called What the Heck? And all you have to do is identify a normal, everyday, standard, bog-standard thing. If you get that right, you win tonight's star prize. Also involved tonight, the feedback reports. And that's probably going to be a lot, actually. Well, it sounds horrible, doesn't it? Yeah. Mm. It's quite a useful one, that, actually. Isn't it? I didn't actually say anything there at all. I just went, yep, mm, and it sounded like I knew what was going on. This is a band called The Beloved and a song called Hello.
So welcome to the world, yeah. All you late comers, just step on board.
Since the Stone Roses had that song in the charts, I think they were in danger of starting a dangerous fashion for people waving their arms about in a slightly Morrissey-ish kind of way. Looking if they've just, as if they've just got out of bed in the morning and probably downed a quart of Feminax. And whining out slightly bleary lyrics. And listen to these names. Can there be any argument at all? These people are completely out of their heads. Yeah, quite. Well done on the synthesizer there, by the way. Okay, I'm just working out some questions to ask you, so here's a bit of music. We'll be right back. You ready yet? Right, here's some questions about the Beautiful South and giving away their LP, Welcome to the Beautiful South. Now, as you well know, bits of the House Martins shredded off that band and went into the Beautiful South. So I'm going to ask you a question like this. What was the House Martins' first LP called? Was it called Welcome to the Beautiful North, Grimsby 5, Watford 8? Now, that's what I call quite good. Hull 4, London 0, Darlington 17, Fendittin 12, or Annick versus Hales Owen, match postponed. Bristol 238877, Gloucester 307575, and Swindon 513366. And Tina Turner, a couple of Tina Turner questions. Yep, true or false question about Tina Turner. In a tabloid newspaper this week, she said, I reach a sexual climax on stage and that's why I'm going back on tour. I usually get to my highest height during the song, What's Love Got to Do with It? That's true or false, number one. And secondly, Tina Turner, true or false? No, okay. Okay, Bristol 238877, Gloucester 307575, and Swindon 513366. So those questions for you very briefly again. The House Martins' first LP was called, well, I'm going to give you a choice here. Was it called Welcome to the Beautiful North? Grimsby 5, Watford 8. Now, that's what I call quite good. Hull 4, London 0. Darlington 17, Fendittin 12. Or Annick versus Hales Owen, game postponed. And secondly, true or false questions about Tina Turner. Number one, is it true that she recently said in a tabloid paper, I reach a sexual climax on stage, and that is why I'm going back on tour. I normally peak during What's Love Got to Do with It? And second part of that question, Tina Turner, true or false? Bristol 238877, Gloucester 307575, and Swindon 513366. Give this away if I remember at all tonight before 11:05. Got a little while to think about it. Correct answers all go into a hat, they get thrown away, and then we'll pull out somebody else's name.
We'll never love in the backseat. let it working.
There's a sound outside the front door, and I know it's just the wind, but it makes them snuggle up just a little bit closer and start things happening again. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Steamy window. It ain't nobody can see. Steamy window. Coming from a body.
Song there, Tina Turner's song called Stevie Windows. That's off the LP Foreign Affair. And giving that away with a beautiful South LP, and I'll give you the questions again a little bit later on. So the winds and stuff, can't forget all the hassle. They actually caused quite a lot of events to be cancelled. I'm sure they did in your area too. Did you know that the following events last week were cancelled? The Hummingbird Races, the Outdoor Table Tennis Championship, the Hang Glider Hamlet, and what was that last one? Let's have a look at that. It's late news. Yeah, just cancelled the flea juggling as well.
He came from somewhere back in how long ago. The sound of every fool don't see, trying hard to recreate what had yet to be created. Once in her life, she musters a smile for his nostalgic tale.
Brothers. Oh, if only half the people who said that knew what Doobie Brothers meant.
It's a question.
Actually, Mike, go away. Go away into your own radio station, would you? For God's sake. Go away. Right, where are we? It's nearly 10:30. Chris Morris, Late No Name Cure.
Yeah, what? Yeah, German.
Oh, yeah, only joking, obviously. Yes, here's tonight's Food Rep Report number one.
What do you think of leaving it out?
Well, people should be able to leave it out if they want to, but there shouldn't be a charge on the community as a whole if they do so.
How long should they leave it out for?
Oh, I think if they should leave it out as long as they like. I mean, people should be entitled to live their own kind of life, but they shouldn't expect other people to look after them then.
Can you see any problems with leaving it out?
Oh, yes, I can, of course, because we have to live as a community.
What about leaving it out and then bringing it back in?
Oh, I think so. I think if you want to do that, yes. That's facing up to the responsibilities of being a citizen, I think.
And what about these people who leave it out and bring it back in so that people think they've brought it back in and then put it out again when no one's looking?
Oh, well, no. I think at the end of the day, you've got to make up your mind about this. Of course, it's a question of age and so on, isn't it?
24.
Oh, I would have thought so. Something like that. Mid-20s, yes.
And finally, what about the people who leave it out, bring it back, then go back and have a look at it?
No, I think we should forget about people like that.
Oh, yeah, I was actually doing that on purpose, it didn't work, did it? Oh dear. Terence Trent Dingbat. Terence, this is me talking. You're making a dick of yourself here. You're a dick. to know someone, actually, a rather good song, one of the best songs off Neither Fish Nor Flesh, that's Terence Trent D'Arby.
Gabriel and Madeleine were just dolls.
Here's something from the papers last week, which reveals that Geoffrey Archer, millionaire author, announced first ever commercial sponsorship in theatre. He says the Playhouse Theatre will get 500,000 quid. Over the next 3 years, and this will finance, from the finance group MI, this will let the theatre launch ventures normally considered uneconomic. For example, exclusive.
Of course, blue string puddings. That guy by Coffee Machine, doesn't it? God, blimey, that sounded a bit threatening, didn't it? Yeah, 21 minutes to 11 on a Friday night. It is the Late No Known Cure. Let me just ask you those questions again for the final time on which you can win the Beautiful South LP and the Tina Turner records we're giving away tonight. Beautiful South, question first of all, what was the name of the House Martins' first LP? Was it called Welcome to the Beautiful North? Was it called Grimsby 5, Watford 8? Now that's what I call quite good. Hull 4, London 0. Darlington 17, Fendittin 12. Annick versus Hales Owen, match postponed. Bristol 238877, Gloucester 307575, and Swindon 513366. You can also answer these two questions. Tina Turner, true or false? She said this week, I'm going back on tour because my performances on stage give me a sexual climax. I peak during What's Love Got to Do with It. I don't know what she peaks at, incidentally. And secondly, Tina Turner, true or false? Bristol 238877, Gloucester 307575, and Swindon 513366.
And now, Wayne Carr, Hyperjog and Star. When he speaks, the world listens.
Okay, and what will Wayne Carr, WC on the radio, your favorite daytime jock and nighttime jock too. We're checking it out. It's Tuesday morning, the 14th of April, 1989. And we're going to check out some of the news, the weather, the local, national and the international time checks for you. We're at the top of the hour, but 20 minutes away at 19 for counting. Okay, we're talking here about some of the latest and the local, national and international news from the Weather Word with the newsroom and the top journalists. We see here that says here that the Yard Press Bureau Chief banned for drink driving. Weird kind of punishment that actually pressing the guy must have been quite painful, I guess, for it to be worthwhile. And here's a weird story from the wacky world of sport. Okay, we're putting this a brand new feature today, Wayne's Wacky World of Sport. And it says here, victory for Bridge Champions. Well, I'm not sure if I agree with that. I mean, it's a historical monument and a wonderful tourist attraction, that ship, down there in Greenwich, isn't it? Don't think it should be given away just to guys who win a game of bridge, okay? I'd like a re-vote on that one if you can. Okay, wait, can't WC on the radio. India warns Pakistan over Kashmir revolt. Well, I'm not surprised there. India's really too damn hot to wear that kind of stuff. And old Gorby is having a bit of trouble there in Russia, of course. And Gorbachev is facing Afghan-style war. You know, I always notice there that the Ruskies are really behind the times. I mean, you know, Afghan. I haven't worn my Afghan for at least 2 years. Romanians dissuade at inept rulers. And that's really sad there because they're not that difficult to make, are they, those rulers, you know? Just get a piece of wood and put a couple of notches on it. And what was the name of the guy, incidentally, that they got rid of over Christmas there? Just have a word with my producer here. What was he called? Oh, bless you. Every time I ask him that question, he always sneezes. Okay, and the Yugoslavs abandoned one-party system. Okay, and that's that's great news, that, because I'd hate to be in a government where they just had a one-party system, all right? I'd like to go to lots of them. And I see here, revealed in the papers last week, DJ John Peely, my old mate Peely there, had a studio sex romp. He made sweet music to his wife during a 25-minute long soundtrack that he was playing on the air. He went and made love to her in the lavatory there at wonderful National Radio 1. Apparently it took him 12 minutes to walk there and 12 minutes to walk back. Okay, I've actually done that myself, you know. But what? My producer's having another one. What are you saying? Yeah, no, it wasn't during It's Not Unusual by Tom Jones, 1 minute 57. No way. No, it wasn't. Okay, and we see here that star Tom Cruise won a couple of awards for his brand new and wonderful performance in a top Hollywood movie this week. Apparently 2,000 showbiz celebrities were at the TV handout there, and there are 24 film stars as well, and they saw loads and loads of TV accolades handed out. Wow, what is an accolade? I wonder if it's an alcoholic drink. I wonder too, you know, just what are you saying? Hang on, my producer got a new producer tonight. He's always saying things. What you say? Huh? He says an accolade is apparently a ventriloquist told him an accolade is a kind of soft drink you get from fruit which comes from an orchard. What are you on about it? No idea what he's saying. Anyway, Wayne Carr, you wonderful daytime jock. This is the Beatles here and Let It Be.
He's trotting into town like he's slinging a gun. Just a small town dude with a big city attitude. Honey, are you looking for some trouble tonight? Well, all right. You think you're so bad, driving women for a while. Shoot them all down with the flash on your pearly smile. Honey, but you met your match tonight. Well, that's right. You think you're knocking me up my feet till I'm flat on the floor. Come on, baby, come on, baby, show me what that love you got is for you.
Jesse James.
You would.
I'm gonna shoot you down, Jesse James.
In point of historical fact, I don't believe Jesse James did go down in flames. Actually, I don't believe that the bullet from a carbine pistol actually produced flames in a human body. We got this piece of news last week from America. One American in 14, apparently, believes that Elvis Presley is still alive. That's according to a survey by top TV news network CBS. Okay, so here we go again. It says in the article, yeah, like hell. That was apparently a very good argument, actually. One of the few, and in fact, one of the increasing number of arguments which are around at the moment, which says that America should no longer be a democracy. That's amongst those people who actually believe it still is.
Okay, relax, pour yourself a stiff Bloody Mary. This is the Christians.
At last I see an open road, and I think I've found a meaning and an answer. Lightened all such a heavy load. Suddenly I'm dancing on earth, and I feel so alive, walking green. Someone smiling again. Since she said she loved me, I'm in heaven. Oh, heaven. I'm stepping out along her street, and a million cares have disappeared. The fog is all around my feet. But I know that my way is clear. I feel so alive, walking green back drive.
Somewhere high above me.
Someone smiling again.
Since she said she loved me,
I'm in heaven. Mm-hmm.
begins to shine and cast its rays upon this rotten town. Now this old town ain't look so fine. Today there's nothing in the world to bring me down. I feel so alive, walking smiling again. Since she said she loved me, I'm in heaven. Somewhere high above me, someone smiling again. Since she said she loved me, I'm in.
Take a seat in the jacuzzi, darling. I'm going to put the new Christians up here on the compact display. Champagne.
Oh, now I'd like some real, thanks. Whip me, whip me.
So, Christians from the new LP, which is called Colour. And I promise sort of half, and if I remember, and anyway, not really at all, that we might be giving away some of that next week. Okay, another competition you don't want to go in for. You can win yourself quite a reasonable prize. I'm not quite sure what it is at the moment, but I know it includes at least a goodie bag and some LPs and some other stuff as well. Then all you have to do is answer this question. We like to have a writing competition occasionally. So this is an anagram competition, and all you have to do is come up with the anagram which we've chosen out of this clue. Atomic Parrot. Atomic Parrot. AtomicParrott. Atomic Parrot. You have to come up with the anagram there. And also, if you could include in your answer, complete the following sentence. I think the average length of a spoon... Sorry, a teaspoon. I think the average length of a teaspoon is... And then put down your guess. So you have to come up with an anagram of Atomic Parrot. And I think the average length of a teaspoon is... And then put your answer there. If you could send that to Tony Clister Talmadge, that's Tony Clister Talmadge, at BBC. You need to send him to this address, right? BBC Broadcasting House, Prospect Place, Swindon, SN1 3RW. Okay, that's BBC Broadcasting House, Prospect Place, Swindon, SN1 3RW. Okay, so that's to Tony Clister Talmadge, and you have to come out with an anagram of Atomic Parrot, and then say what you think the average length of a teaspoon in the United Kingdom is, and you can win yourself a pretty nice goodie bag there, and a day out on the listener's trip, and also you can win yourself a couple of LP prizes as well. So it's great, and I think a free visit round the station, so well worth going in for that, and address it there to Tony Clister Talmadge, Broadcasting House, Prospect Place, Swindon, SN1 3RW. You can't say that I didn't give you all the information you need for that, and you have to have the answers in by the end of this week. It's a question I just can't answer myself. I see in The Sun that every week they print on Monday, they have the Monday Moan, okay, edited by Sue Cook, and it says, you're charged to speak your mind. It just has a blank page after it. Speak. Police, rather, obviously, there. Feedback report number two for tonight.
What do you think of shooting horses?
Well, one hardly shoots horses for sport.
What does one do it for?
Presumably, only if necessary.
What sort of speed should they be shot at?
As quickly as possible.
And who should they be shot at?
Well, presumably a qualified veterinary surgeon.
Quite seriously, I have to insist that I do not cut those feedback reports a bad save to reduce the amount of time that they last by editing them. I do not change the sentence. Really irks me to have to say that, but one or two highly suspicious and cynical people actually believe that I ask different questions. It is not true, and this is the only lie I'm not going to tell tonight.
Oh, lover boy, do you have to long? Maybe one day you wake and you'll find me gone. Lover boy, call me home. I'll come driving fast as wheels can answer.
Driving.
this great trick you can do, right? Great trick, okay? They got these talking litter bins, okay, and they say thank you every 5 minutes, right? Say thank you for keeping the streets tidy every 5 minutes. So what you do is, right, you get this huge sack of rubbish, really vile, disgusting, decaying rubbish, kind of compost kind of rubbish with stinky fish bones in it and stuff. And you go up and you stand by one of these litter bins, okay, and you count 4 minutes, right? 4 minutes and 57 seconds, right, since the last time it says thank you. And then you empty all the stuff over the street, okay? And then it says, thanks for keeping the streets tidy. All right, let me give you these clues. Here they are, describing a normal everyday thing.
You hear it at a marriage ceremony.
It's quite often associated with doing something stupid.
It's ultimately more important than blowing a punch on the hard shoulder.
I don't see them written down very often.
Oh, I suppose they're always shorter than the duration of the 6 o'clock news.
To the average person, they're caused by dogs about once a week.
OK, if you want to have a go in that competition, Bristol 238877, Gloucester 307575 and Swindon 513366. Here they are again.
You hear it at a marriage ceremony.
It's quite often associated with doing something stupid.
It's ultimately more important than blowing a punch on the hard shoulder.
I don't see them written down very often.
Oh, I suppose they're always shorter than the duration of the 6 o'clock news.
To the average person, they're caused by dogs about once a week.
Okay, believe it or not, those people have actually described a normal everyday event, incident or thing. All you have to do is pinpoint exactly which one it is, or alternatively just phone up with a gratuitously wrong answer and get yourself on the radio and see how long you can stay on for. Bristol 238877, Gloucester 307575 and Swindon 513366. I'll guarantee you that if you're a sword swallower, you will stay on much longer than if you are just a normal, boring, old, drab person. Okay, so if you'd like to phone in and stay on the radio as long as you can, and I'd say you've got about 12 minutes before the first round of that competition, feeling in a fit of ridiculous generosity, I'll play the clues again.
You'll hear it at a marriage ceremony.
It's quite often associated with doing something stupid.
It's ultimately more important than blowing a punch on the hard shoulder.
I don't see them written down very often.
Oh, I suppose they're always shorter than the duration of the 6 o'clock news.
To the average person, they're caused by dogs about once a week.
Okay, so if you want to take part, you know what to do. I'd like to dedicate this song to anyone who's just been dozing off to sleep and was just thinking,
hey, you was a
Dalek. Never.
David Byrne and the Dream Police. And it's a few minutes after a certain hour in the day of, certain day of the week, really. Late No Known Cure, this is. I'm Chris Morris. We're about to discover the winner of the competition. Maybe remember I set some questions earlier about Tina Turner and the Beautiful South. What was the name of the Beautiful South's first LP? Let me just riffle through and see if I can actually find the questions I set. If not, I'll just have to make up some different ones. So the first question was Jimmy Cotton. No, it's a question about the Beautiful South, and it was, what's their first LP? Well, the name of the first LP from the House Martins, actually, was Hull 4, London 0. Second question was, is it true that Tina Turner was rambling on this week about going back on tour because she finds that she reaches a sexual climax and, in fact, peaks during What's Love Got to Do with It? Well, that was, in fact, true. And the third question, Tina Turner, true or false? Absolute slap round the chops if you even bother to answer that. Quite a lot of people actually phoned up and said Tina Turner, false. This could constitute a libel of some sort, or at least damaging comments about the nature of her character. Of course, the correct answer, really, if we're being pernickety, is Tina Turner, a mild percentage false, but not nearly as much as Cher. So we're going to have a word with... Well, actually, we won't. We'll just say congratulations to Kathy Takeall. Yeah, she made that up, didn't she? For goodness sake. From Fishponds. Won that Tina Turner LP, Foreign Affair, and this from the Beautiful South with the silliest line of 89.
I love you from the bottom of my pencil case. I love you in the songs I write and sing. Love you because you put me in my rightful place. And I love you. That you bring cheap, never cheap. I'll sing your songs till you're asleep. When you've gone upstairs, I'll creep and write it all down, down, down. Oh, Shelley, oh, Deborah, oh, Julie, oh, Jane. So many songs about you. I forget your name. I forget your name.
Jennifer, Allison, Philippa Sue, Deborah, Annabelle too.
I forget your name.
Jennifer, Allison, Philippa Sue, Deborah, Annabelle too.
I forget your name.
Actually a particularly silly question.
I wonder what's more likely to stand for Parliament, an armchair or a fish?
Well, that, if I may say, is actually a particularly silly question.
Oh.
Song for you.
Jennifer, Allison, Philippa Sue, for Deborah, Annabelle too.
I wrote the song for you.
Jennifer, Allison, Philippa Sue, for
What if penguins ever think about giving up smoking?
Well, that's, if I may say, is actually a particularly silly question.
So let me talk about Mary, sad star, turning her grief into glory. Talk about Mary, sad star, turning her grief into glory. The tide right alive, rip his ribbon to shreds. Late at night, and the tide right alive, rip his ribbon to shreds. So let me talk about Mary, a sad star, turn her grief into glory. Talk about Mary.
I wonder who lies down more often, if it's ex-President Nixon or his pet aunt Rodney.
Well, that's, if I may say, is actually a particularly silly question.
Right alive. Yeah.
Chad?
Hello?
Chad, is it you that, as a child, was going to tell us about your experience as a child tonight? I had to be weaned off the dangerous habit of head-butting combine harvesters, wasn't it?
I was never a child, I don't think.
All right. Time to start now, then, really.
I wrote this song for you.
Never understand why it does that at the end. It's really sort of tacky, isn't it? And obviously, look, the tape came off the spool or something. Robert from Cheltenham, hello, Bob.
Hello.
How are you?
Oh, fine, thanks.
Good.
Can you tell me what the biggest type of caterpillar in the world is, please?
The biggest what?
Caterpillar in the world.
The biggest kind of caterpillar? Do you have the correct answer for this?
Well, no, I don't know. You're the expert, aren't you? Everyone knows Johnny Morris is the expert on animals.
Robert, one more stupid comment. You won't even be allowed to answer your question.
What question?
The question which you phoned up for, remember?
No.
Right, bye. And it's Chad from Bath. Hello.
Hello.
Okay, Chad, what's your answer?
I think it's nerves.
Nerves. No, sorry, we can't give you that one, Chad.
Okay.
Thanks for calling.
Thank you, bye.
Okay, let's give Robert a second chance. Robert, do you have a sensible answer for us?
Yeah, is it a bus stop?
Well, hardly a sensible answer, but anyway, you've got a chance to squeeze it out. What?
Can I come on? Can you give me a badge?
No, just go away. It's Mark from Wales, hello.
Hello.
Hi, Mark, I hope you're going to be rather less boring than that. What are you doing tonight?
Me? I'm sat in bed.
Sat in bed?
Yeah.
And for how much longer will you maintain that position, do you think? You're probably actually going to go to sleep as soon as you've got the competition wrong, aren't you?
Probably.
You're not going to stick around and find out what the right answer is.
Well, I do.
Would you like to say hello to someone before you go?
Yeah, hello to Gabs in Shepton, if he's listening.
To Gabs?
Yeah.
Right, and what's he doing at this time of night, do you reckon? Fine, okay. And what's your answer?
I think it's a fart.
You just wanted to say fart on the radio, really, didn't you? Mark, go away.
Okay.
Bye. So it's Bristol 238877. Honestly, it's late night radio, isn't it? I mean, blimey, we asked for it really being on at this time of night. Adolescents who got bored with pressing their spots and people who phone up and want to say fart. Bristol 238877, Gloucester 307575, and Swindon 513366. Can you raise the tone? Wouldn't be difficult, really, even if you were a warbler. Here are the clues. See if we can get the right answer.
You hear it at a marriage ceremony.
It's quite often associated with doing something stupid.
It's ultimately more important than blowing a puncher on the hard shoulder.
I don't see them written down very often.
Oh, I suppose they're always shorter than the duration of the 6 o'clock news.
To the average person, they're caused by dogs about once a week.
So what is that that those people have just described? I'm going to give you another chance because clearly it's not enough to hear the clues. Have to listen to them very carefully and then see what these people could be... I mean, they are... Actually, I thought it was quite obvious. Particularly the first two clues seem to point you in the right direction. I mean, some of the rest were, you know, a bit ridiculous. But have a listen again. All right, try this time then.
You'll hear it at a marriage ceremony.
It's quite often associated with doing something stupid.
It's ultimately more important than blowing a puncher on the hard shoulder.
I don't see them written down very often.
Oh, I suppose they're always shorter than the duration of the 6 o'clock news.
To the average person, they're caused by dogs about once a week.
OK, you know the numbers. If you win tonight, we can win compact discs. We've got a couple of LPs to give away, some compact disc singles, some Nanocure badges, some bits of paper, And before I get to the end of this lungful of air, I've got to tell you one other thing. Oh, yes, tickets to Canon Cinema of your choice. So if you have much choice, really, go to an Odeon and say, is this a Canon Cinema of choice? No. But anyway, you can see, go and see a reasonable, decent selection of films and those. Plus, of course, tonight's Star Prize.
It comes around every year, and yet it still hasn't been abolished. What is it?
Panto season.
And that's why we're giving away a full guide to getting the most out of it, including a glossary of the terms.
Dame.
A dame is a man dressed up as a woman with very little attempt to hide his masculinity. Therefore designed as a trick on children, see also Principal Boy, so that they grow up thinking it's quite acceptable to be a transvestite, and then find if they tried themselves, they are branded sick, perverted weirdos.
Pantomime horse.
Pantomime horse is a medical condition thoroughly deserved by those given to shouting, hello, boys and girls. Oh, no, it isn't. Oompa, oompa, stick it up.
And pantomime itself.
And pantomime itself is derived from the Greek panto for all, and mimos, a caricatural drama. It therefore means a charity which for a full 3 months every year prolongs the careers of so-called entertainers, decerebral presenters of children's television, ex-newsreaders, comedians, and Gary Wilmot to well past their sell-by date. It therefore represents the only activity in this country which should be reconsidered as a capital offence, I thank you.
And in response to your probing questions like, what do they all mean?
We include an interview with one of those people who's discovered just how lucrative it can be to bring out a book which attributes sexual imagery to every children's story you can think of. Jack and the Beanstalk.
Well, I think the Beanstalk's obviously phallic.
Ah, yes. What about Puss in Boots?
Well, the female counterpart, Puss in Boots.
And Dick Whittington?
Well, I mean, really, we're back to the phallic again with Dick, aren't we?
Oh, yes, of course. It's all true, of course. You only have to look at the cast list to see that every panto is full of dicks. And we're giving it all away. That complete guide to the form of family entertainment, which is about as amusing as a pus sandwich.
We're picking up stray dogs every day.
This, by the way, is Tim Buck.
Three.
We'll be right back. Well, that's Timbuktu 3 and called National Holiday. That is, that's a new single. Here's tonight's running joke for some reason.
Music from the Motor City.
And here's tonight's feedback report number 3. Well, looking at frames of mind, I think it's a good idea to be in a frame of mind.
Yes.
What sort's a good one? Any others?
Yes. When I go shopping.
What sort of frame of mind there?
A frame of mind where I want to look at shops and that.
Would you say it's a bad thing to be in a bad frame of mind?
Oh, yes. Beyond all doubt.
And what do you think is the best shape for the ideal frame of mind?
A circular shape.
And what should it be made of, ideally?
Timber. Wood.
Any particular sort of a wood?
Soft wood.
And what sort of size?
Oh, 6 inches diameter. The last good thing they did, really, isn't it? Rolling Stones and Shattered. There's been quite a lot of press this week given to the European Economic Community
booklet, which is a full list of acronyms, of some of the most ridiculous acronyms I think you've come across. Acronym, really, people who invent the acronyms for their particular societies seem to be devoting themselves to one of the most pointless occupations I think man can do. DRIVE, for example, means Dedicated Road Infrastructure for Vehicle Safety in Europe. SAVE is the Special Action Programme for Vigorous Energy Efficiency. Others, such as ECLAIR, the European Collaborative Linkage of Agriculture and Industry through Research. You could dare say the society that's brought all this up would be the Brussels United Language Lovers Society for Highlighting Idiotic Terminology. River Detectives.
Wanted to wake you up last night just to ask you how you've been. Something got caught in her halfway heart and the words got broken again. Shudder inside when he sees that look in her eye. A hurricane love for electric night. You never know what's inside. Maybe you don't understand. You got nothing left to be. And she said, you don't know. He's a boy on a swing, pick him up when he falls. She's a girl about to break. Maybe you don't understand. You got nothing left to take. And she said, you don't know.
So, River Detectives, you don't know a thing about love. This is a little extract coming up here from Radio 4's funniest programme of the week.
No hint of a cut in interest rates.
See what I mean? OK, there's Neil from Cheltenham we'll have a quick word with. Hello, Neil.
Yeah, hello, Chris.
How are you?
I'm fine, thanks.
Good, OK, what have you got planned for the weekend?
Well, I'm just going up.
Do you have a rest, do you have a rest sort of against the wall with your hand sort of bent over backwards and just leaning against your hip, like, just like that, yeah?
Yeah, every now and then, yeah.
You do. It's good, isn't it? It's nice and relaxing.
Yeah, can I just say that I prefer plastic dustbins to the metal ones?
Yeah, and what would you like to give us an answer as well, Neil?
Well, yeah, I deduced it was a bowl of cornflakes, actually.
Right, okay. And would you like to explain the dustbin relevance there?
Well, you know when the dustman comes on Thursday mornings?
Yeah.
It's a lot quieter with the plastic ones, because you don't make so much noise.
Okay, Neil, consider that your session on the soapbox is now over and you have to go away and crawl back into the hideous obscurity from whence you came.
Yeah, okay, that's fine.
Thanks for calling. Bye-bye.
Okay, bye.
It's Chris from Little Stoke. Hello.
Hello there.
How are you, Chris?
I'm fine, and you?
Consider yourself ugly or sort of pretty good looking, really?
Nah, quite attractive to women, actually.
Are you?
Yeah.
You sure?
Yeah, sure, yeah.
How many girlfriends do you reckon you've, got through in your few years outside?
I don't know, I lost count, really.
Yeah, really? Well, it's not difficult, is it? Could be anything above four, then. What's your answer?
Well, I think it's wrong, actually. I thought it was a serious row, but some of the clues don't tie up.
Yeah, well, not to worry anyway. It doesn't particularly mean that you are wrong. Although, in this case, I have to say, Chris, that you are.
Oh, dear.
But, yeah, never mind, eh?
Oh, well, it was worth a try, wasn't it?
Yeah, it was, actually, wasn't it? Yeah. Slap your head, go on.
Just one thing.
Oh, blimey, he's off again, yeah?
Have you got long hair and do you drive a Maserati?
Go away.
No?
Go away. Bye-bye, Chris.
Bye.
It's got to be Matt from Worcester.
Hello.
Hello, Matt. What do your friends call you?
Matthew, I suppose.
They call you Matty, I suppose.
Matthew.
Matthew?
Mm.
Right, and what's your middle name?
James.
And how do you pronounce Siren Zester?
Same as you do.
And what about the idea of having carpet on the wall? Do you think it's a good one?
Well, in posh places, yeah.
Okay, and what about the colour blue? Think it's a suitable colour for stockings?
Looks good in the sky.
Right. And finally, how many eyes do you think would be best number for people to have, you know, in an ideal world?
It depends.
Okay, that's the wrong answer, but never mind. We'll keep you on. What do you think is the right answer for this particular quiz?
Is it a kiss?
Oh, Matt, come on. Yeah, soppy old ridiculous herring. Seriously, you think it's a kiss?
Yeah.
Oh, yes, he said regretfully.
Mm.
When was the last time you experienced one of those, Matt?
Well, not that long ago.
No, I'm talking about the full communication of juices kind of kiss.
Well, it's a bit personal, isn't it?
No. Is it?
Well, when did you last have one?
Yesterday.
Oh.
Sorry, today. Do you mind people being personal?
Depends.
What about this? Goodbye. Bristol 238877, Gloucester 307575, that was real, and Swindon 513366. Here are the clues again.
You'll hear it at a marriage ceremony.
It's quite stupid.
It's ultimately more important than blowing a punch on the hard shoulder.
I don't see them written down very often.
Oh, I suppose they're always shorter than the duration of the 6 o'clock news.
To the average person, they're calls by dogs about once a week.
OK, the numbers again, Bristol 238877. Gloucester 307575 and Swindon 513366. And in case you're wondering, I'm not the sort of person that would queue up that kind of sound effect on a cartridge. I'd much rather wait until the real thing is actually ready to erupt at precisely the right moment and then do it for you in the full glory of live transmission. The quality always deteriorates on tape.
Not looking for Linda, but Linda found me hiding away on the slow train home. Is this one for Paisley, or you got to help me? She used to work there a long time ago. She spent £35 and one pack of ciggies running an errand for him and kept running straight down to Leeds Central, took in the city and left her immortal. Look at how for Linda, never stop looking, never stop looking for Linda. Looking out for Linda, never stop looking. Was pleased. She'd been fighting fire water all that day. She said, "Me and drinking means only one thing." Whispered that she was too polite to say. The train door was jammed, but the time wasn't right. Some guy was holding her back from the window. I said, "A fine man," she said, "so
That's Hue and Cry, and Looking Out for Linda. I'm about to play a track from the new Tinita Tikaram LP, which I'll try and give away for you same time next week. I've got another one brewing up, by the way, in case you're wondering. I'll see if I can save it for the next round of phone calls. It's probably what you expected, actually. It's called The Sweet Keeper, and it's sort of mainly quite dour and moody, and looks quite like a photo, which looks quite like sort of Lloyd Cole trying to look incredibly butch, except you've got a sort of great big lock of hair flopping over the front. And it's got one or two jolly tracks on it as well. And we'll play this for anyone who's just sat down and then stood up again and then sat down and crossed their legs and then stood up again and thought, blimey, and then forgot what they were thinking about and then went to the kitchen, made themselves a cup of coffee, poured it over their left hand, then got three cats in from outside, bit their heads off, and then decided that they'd suck out the kind of stomach contents but stop when they got to the duodenal... Okay, we will sort out the competition before the end of the programme. In case you missed it earlier, this is an extract from tonight's edition of The Organist Entertains. Take this opportunity to say that if you did find yourself winning the LP competition and your name was, I can't remember what it was, but anyway, you heard me read it out earlier. If you were the winner of that, and if you'd like to phone in again now, because we've actually discovered that the number that you gave we cannot get through to, so it was either a very good joke. What was your name? It was something like Takes All, wasn't it? She wasn't called Wendy Winner Takes All or something, was she? No, right. This is from The Organist Entertains, which happens on Radio 2 every night, I think Friday night at 9:30, and definitely takes the prize for the least aptly named radio programme in the business. And here's tonight's feedback report number four. What do you think of this brand new idea of residential chickens?
What, battery hens?
Absolutely right. Quite specifically, integrating battery hens with modern housing development schemes.
Yeah, I agree with that.
Why not?
Well, I think that most modern housing sites should be away from all that. I mean, I go along with the idea...
Away from all the chickens and their influences.
Right.
Why? Do you think it leads to a decline in social behaviour?
Yeah, definitely.
What's the biggest evil that a chicken inflicts in terms of its influence?
Well, the fact that just brings the tone of the neighbourhood then, that's all.
So if that tone started off as a middle C, do you think it would get down as far as bottom E flat?
Oh, it probably would, yeah.
This does go on for a long time. So we'd better have a word with Joy from Temple Cloud. Joy?
Yes?
What's your wrong answer?
A vow.
All right, then. Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.
Jonathan, what's your incorrect answer?
A vow.
All right, then. Bye-bye. Thanks.
That's okay.
I love that bit in the video of this song with the Michael Jackson appearance. He has a walk-on part. Have you seen that? It's about 2 minutes through and he just walks across the back. Yeah, he's such a sense of humour, that guy. He doesn't even look at the camera. That's what I like. It's a true professional. Doesn't flinch. Trips, though, slightly. She met Michael Jackson in a changing room once. You know, you wouldn't believe the truth of it. Totally bald. Got Michael from... No, what is this? Isn't making sense at all. What's all this Dan from Brent Noel nonsense? What line's he on? Let's have a word with Michael anyway. Hello, Michael.
Hello.
Oh, how are you?
All right, thanks.
Shall I stop this record?
No.
You like it, do you?
No.
You don't?
No.
Oh, stop it then. What's your answer?
Is it a collar?
A collar?
Yeah.
Oh. Damn, you know, when you thought, obviously, when I said it was wrong before, that I was just joking.
Yeah.
No, Michael, but I'd like to give you a chance to say four more words. Choose them carefully. Got all the time in the world. I won't count those as words.
I don't know.
1, 2, 3. And one more?
Yeah.
All right, then. Bye-bye. So we've got a word with... I don't believe he's on line 8. There is no such thing. But, well, I mean, I can only suggest that he might be here. Hello? Anyone there? No? Where's the winner? Hang on, let me just kind of play with this off for a second. Well, it doesn't appear to be there, so we'll have to have another record. And we've only got 8 minutes left. If you think you won, give us a call.
Sunday morning brings the dawn. It's just a restless feeling by my side. Early dawning, Sunday morning. It's just the wasted years so close behind. Watch out, the world's behind. There's always someone around you who will call. It's nothing at all. Sunday morning, and I'm falling. I've got a feeling I don't want to know. It's all the streets you crossed not so long.
Very accurate cover there of the Velvet Underground song as Burl Ives and Isla Sinclair, Sunday Morning. Joy from... No, we can't have it. No, we must be having just one person more. Hello? Is that Dan? Hello, Dan? No sign of Dan at all. Hello, Dan?
Hello there.
How are you?
Not too bad.
Good. And what have you been doing today?
Well, I've been to school today.
What?
I've been to school today.
Really? What were you doing there? Looking through the bushes?
Frog knotting today.
Frog knotting?
Yeah.
Can you explain frog knotting to me?
Well, you sort of get this frog.
Which frog?
Well, sort of Eric the Frog.
Mm-hmm.
And you knot it.
Right, which is the easiest bit to tie a knot in?
Well, the back end...
I wouldn't normally be doing this, indulging in living. We've got a bit of time to waste. Sorry, what?
The back end, if you sort of get the back end...
Yes,
and together and
right.
Interwind the
two. Okay. And what's your answer? Amen. What?
Sorry?
What's your answer?
My answer is an oath.
God, blimey, Zach, you got that right. Dan, stay on the line. We'll take your address and we'll send you the prizes.
Thank you very much.
Thanks for calling.
Thanks, bye.
Bye. Bye. So the answer was... an oath. And here are the clues to prove it.
You hear it at a marriage ceremony.
It's quite often associated with doing something stupid.
It's ultimately more important than blowing a punch on the hard shoulder.
I don't see them written down very often.
Oh, I suppose they're always shorter than the duration of the 6 o'clock news.
To the average person, they're caused by dogs about once a week.
So that was it. Just trying to find the other competition, the write-in competition that we were talking about. Well, I have to let you know after this, and I'll give you the address to write into too. This is Eric Clapton's latest single, it's called Bad Love. Good letter here. It says, Dear Chris, why don't you ever listen to Radio 1 on Friday nights? I'll show you why. See what I mean? Okay, here's the writing competition. You want to take part in it? What you have to do is find an anagram out of this clue, atomic parrot. And also, if you can write in with your guess at the average length of a teaspoon in the United Kingdom. All you need to write to do then is jot your answers down on a postcard and write to Tony Clister Talmadge. And he's at Broadcasting House. And that is Prospect Place, Swindon, SN1, 3RW. So that's Prospect Place, Swindon, SN1, 3RW. Get an anagram out of Atomic Parrot. And if you can give your guess at the average length of a teaspoon in the UK, write to Tony Clister Talmadge. Get your answers in by this time next week. We'll have a prize for you then. That's it from me tonight. I'll see you at 10 o'clock next Friday night. Up next is the Midnight News Summary.
Radio 2. The news at midnight. This is Steve Madden. Hundreds of thousands of people are spending a second night without electricity after Thursday's storm. The Soviet Defense Minister has spoken of his determination to continue the crackdown of nationalist groups in Azerbaijan. East Germany's opposition groups have agreed to join the communists in governing the country. Work is continuing to restore power and phone links in areas worst hit by the storms on Thursday. More than a quarter of a million homes in the south of England still have no electricity. The number of dead is now put at 46.
Downloaded from Cooked and Bombed, www.cookedandbombed.co.uk or chilled.green.org.